Okay, thank you, Ana Rita. My presentation is about female identity on holy women portrayed in Spanish realist novel. As it happened in the 15th and 16th centuries with enlightened saints, 19th century was a pivotal moment for the building of female identity. In the field of literature, historically as well as fictionally, we find the name of women who struggled to reformulate the meanings of female identity and self-identity. Specifically, in Spain, we find great names such as Gertrudis Gómez de Avellaneda, Cecilia Boldefaber, or Emilia Pardo Bazán, which constructed a necessary self-identity for women by trying to actively be part of the literary society of their time, a self-identity that, in some cases, was misunderstood or even persecuted. Regarding a realistic novel, several female personalities remain, which, following the example of religious models such as Maria de Santo Domingo, tackle sexist and patriarchal society they live in and aim for thoroughly fulfill themselves as human beings equal to men. From Guillermina Pacheco, Fortunata y Jacinta, who funds a congregation for orphan children, to the Countess of Alma, which builds a Christian phalanstery for poor people, together with Benina Misericordia, a kind of woman messiah which brings hope to her society through charity, all of them found a new single but also collective identity for women. But this search for female identity in the 19th century Spanish novel began some decades before in Romanticism. In this way, characters such as Matilde de Urgel, protagonist of Los Bandos de Castilla o El Caballero del Cisne by Ramón López Soler, or Beatriz, heroine of El Señor de Bembibre by Enrique Gil y Carrasco, already presented an individual authority that led them to confront the male world where they live in. However, their personality did not manage to prevail among that of the rest of the men around them. For this to happen, they should pass many years until the realism literary current arrived in Spain. This movement, which began in Spain in the 1817s and became established in the following decade with the appearance of the naturalism, has had as protagonists of its novel female characters who develop their existence in contemporary society. Novels such as Pepita Jiménez, Doña Perfecta, La Desheredada, or La Tribuna are examples from their own titles of the interest that the great novelists of the time saw for the female world, an interest that was maintained throughout that decade and the following one, in which the spiritualist stage began. Therefore, writers such as Pedro Antonio de Alarcón with La Pródiga, Leopoldo Alas Clarín with La Regenta, Benito Pérez Galdós with La de Bringas, among others, or José María de Pereda with La Montalvez, address novels to the character of women and their position in contemporary society. The same did Emilia Pardo Bazán, who, especially in the spiritualist stage of the 90s, published novels such as Una Cristiana, La Prueba, or Doña Milagros, where she addressed the position of women and their problems in contemporary reality. Among all of these great writers, the one who possibly most investigated the problem of female identity was Benito Pérez Galdós, who dedicated a large part of his novelistic corpus to women. Gloria, Tormento, Tristana, or Cassandra So the constant interest of the Canadian novelist to delve into the feminine identity throughout his entire career. His masterpiece, Fortunata y Jacinta, subtitled Dos Historias de Casadas, presents the lives of two women in the period from the 1868 Revolution to Bourbon Restoration. The struggle for the achievement of feminine identity is an essential subject in all the Galdosian novels that we have just mentioned. Curiously, within all of them, the characters who fiercely rebel against their inferior position in 19th century society and secondly manage to establish themselves as a personal authority not subjugated to the world of men are women belonging to the religious sphere. In this regard, the three most important examples are Guillermina Pacheco from Fortunata y Jacinta, Catalina de Artal from Alma, and Benina, protagonist of Misericordia. In this presentation, I am going to focus on the first two of them who share the characteristics of belonging to a high social class and being the founders of two religious congregations for the needy. The aristocrat Guillermina Pacheco, one of the most important supporting characters in Fortunata y Jacinta, appears to us a woman who, breaking all the social rules of the time, decides not to marry and dedicates her life and money to the founding of an asylum for orphans. Her story and her person are known under the heading Guillermina, Virgen y Fundadora. The narrator explains about her. Lo que la familia admite es que la muerte de su madre la impresionó tan vivamente que hubo de proponerse no servir a más señores que se le pudieran morir. No nació aquella sin igual mujer para la vida contemplativa. Era un temperamento soñador, activo y emprendedor, un espíritu con ideas propias y con iniciativas varoniles. No se le hacía cuesta arriba la disciplina en el terreno espiritual, pero en el material sí, por lo cual no pensó nunca en afiliarse a ninguna de las órdenes religiosas más o menos severas que hay en el orbe católico. No se reconocía con bastante paciencia para encerrarse y estar todo el santo día bostezando el gorigori, ni para ser soldado en los valientes escuadrones de Hermanas de la Caridad. La llama vivísima que en su pecho ardía no le inspiraba la sumisión pasiva, sino actividades iniciadoras que debían desarrollarse en la libertad. Tenía un carácter inflexible y un tesoro de dotes de mando y de facultades de organización que ya quisieran para sí algunos de los hombres que dirigen los destinos del mundo. Era mujer que cuando se proponía algo iba a su fin derecha como una bala, con perseverancia grandiosa, sin torcerse nunca ni desmayar un momento, inflexible y serena. Si en este camino recto encontraba espinas, las pisaba y adelante, con los pies ensangrentados. Her own ideas, inflexible character and authority are linked to another fundamental peculiarity in which Guillermina manifests her personal identity, rebelliousness. A rebellion that drives her to confront the society of which she is a part and that does not understand the nature of this lady for her behavior. La asociación benéfica a que pertenecía no se acomodaba al ánimo emprendedor de Guillermina, pues quería ella picar más alto, intentando cosas verdaderamente difíciles y tenidas por imposibles. Sus talentos de fundadora se revelaron entonces, asustando a todo aquel señorío que no sabía salir de ciertas rutinas. Algunas amigas suyas aseguraron que estaba loca porque demencia era pensar en la fundación de un asilo para huerfanitos y mayor locura dotarle de recursos permanentes. Pero la infatigable iniciadora no desmayaba y el asilo fue hecho, sosteniéndose en los tres primeros años de su difícil existencia con parte de la renta que le quedaba a Guillermina y con los donativos de sus parientes ricos. In the same way as Guillermina managed to carry out her project, despite social impediments, Catalina de Artal, the protagonist of Alma, has to face the same problems. Catalina is a countess who, after the death abroad of her husband, returns to Spain and decides to found a new religious order. In a conversation with her brother, the Marquess of Feramore, we discover that Catalina also has thus ideas of her own, ideas propias, that Guillermina Pacheco has. Eso es lo que yo temo, señora hermana. Y cuando te oigo decir tengo mis ideas, me echo a temblar, porque los hechos me prueban que tus ideas no son de una perfecta congruencia con la realidad. The social incomprehension, which is shown in this case through the protagonist brother, makes her rebel and defend her ideas. Ello es que las tengo, querido hermano, dijo la condesa de Alma con humildad, y tú tienes las tuyas. Fácil es que no concuerden unas con otras. Pensamos, sentimos la vida de un modo muy distinto. Déjame a mí por mi camino y sigue tú el tuyo. Quizás nos encontremos, quizás no. Eso quién lo sabe. Cierto es que yo quiero hacer vida religiosa. No puedo decirte aún si entraré en las órdenes antiguas o en las modernas. Soy un poco lenta en mis resoluciones y mis ideas han de madurar mucho para que yo me decida a ponerlas en práctica. Quizás te sorprenda con algún proyectillo que pase un poquito la línea de lo común. No sé. Cada cual tiene sus aspiraciones. Yo las tengo en mi esfera como tú en la tuya. This defense of their own aspirations, of their own personal fulfillment, shows an inflexible character like that of Guillermina, willing to achieve their goals over and above any social obstacle. The female rebellion once again clashes with the male chauvinist environment that considers Catalina's project crazy. However, the female authority of the counties overcomes the impediments and finally the religious foundation of Catalina is carried out. Pues esta señora que ha venido a Pedralba en carromato no ha traído más que los indispensables objetos tocantes al aseo y pulcritud de una doble dama que aún en la penitencia quiere ser limpia. Y su séquito es una corte de mendigos y gente miserable o enferma a cuyo cuidado piensa consagrarse. Ejemplo único, señores, ejemplo inaudito y que es la más grande maravilla de estos tiempos de positivismo, de estos tiempos de egoísmo, de estos tiempos de materialismo. Luego, dijo Urrea con entrañable gozo, convienen ustedes conmigo en que mi prima es una excepción humana, un ser en el cual se revelan los caracteres de la inspiración divina. Sí, señor, convenimos en ello. ¿Y el buen curita qué dice? ¿Qué he de decir yo? Contestó modestamente don Nazario, no queriendo expresar nada que resultara superior a lo dicho por su generoso compañero. ¿Qué he de decir yo después del panegírico elocuentísimo que acaba de hacer el señor cura? Mi palabra es torpe. Permítanme que diga tan solo, bendita sea de Dios eternamente la grande, la santa condesa de Alma. Finally, as happened with Guillermina, the counties manages to carry out her religious foundation, in this case, a kind of Christian phalanstery in the middle of the countryside where poor people live. In this way, Catalina becomes a feminine authority recognized for the rest of characters, both men and women. Their own ideals, indomitable personality and confrontation with society are characteristics that led this protagonist to form their feminine identity. All these behaviors are based on an essential characteristic, rebelliousness. Guillermina and Catalina rebel against the male world in order to conduct their ideal of life. The former confronts first of all, her family and her friends in order to found the hospice. Catalina, on the other hand, confronts her brother to found her congregation. Rebellion, as Professor Gomez Moreno has studied, is a topic present in many lives of saints since the Middle Ages. These characteristics, which made the woman saints confront the masculine world of which they were part and establish themselves as a religious authority, has its origin in medieval and baroque hagiographies, such as Legenda Aurea and Flores Santorum. These hagiographies reached the 18th and 19th centuries in Spain through a work called El Año Cristiano, written by Jean Croiset and translated into Spanish by José Francisco de Isla. El Año Cristiano is a 12-volume hagiography that traces the biography of all the saints day by day throughout the year. The reading of this work, as demonstrated by many realistic novels, was common among women of the time, and it was undoubtedly a source of inspiration for many of them. After all, Guillermina and Catalina are two founding saints who, through various ways, managed to rebel against society and establish themselves as an authority through religion. This reality was carried out by women such as Teresa de Jesús or Catalina de Siena, and also the living saints, Juana de la Cruz or María de Santo Domingo, among others, whose catalog we have just seen. This catalog, which is still a great hagiography, collects the lives of many holy women of the 15th and 16th centuries who already at that time achieved their own personal identity. In view of this catalog and as a future wish, it would be interesting to create a digital database for the study of this protagonist of the Spanish realist novel. Thank you for your attention.
Many thanks to you. Let's now move on to our last